All living being need water to live. Water is important for a proper growth and development of flowers, fruits, and seeds of plants. Water is absorbed by the plant roots along with water, minerals, and fertilizers are also absorbed. Plants contain nearly 90% water. Water is essential because germination of seeds does not take place under dry conditions. Nutrients dissolved in water get transported to each part of the plant. Water also protects the crop from both frost and hot air current. To maintain the moisture of the soil for a healthy crop growth, fields have to be watered regularly. The supply of water to crops at different intervals is called irrigation. The time and the frequency of irrigation varies from crops to crop, soil to soil, and season to season. In summer, the frequency of watering is higher. Why is it so? Could it be due to increased rate of evaporation of water from the soil and the leaves? Source of irrigation. The sources of irrigation are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, and canals. Traditional method of irrigation. The water available in wells, lakes, and canals is lifted up by different methods in different regions for taking it to the fields. Cattle or human labor is used in these methods. So, these methods are cheaper but less efficient. The various traditional ways are moat, it means pulley system or chain pump. Third is dhekli and rahat, that is a lever system. Pumps are commonly used for lifting water. Diesel, biogas, electricity, and solar energy is used to run these pumps. Modern method of irrigation. Modern methods of irrigation helps us to use water economically. The main method used are as follows. First is sprinkler system. This system is more useful on the uneven land where sufficient water is not available. The perpendicular pipes having rotating nozzles on top are joined to the main pipeline at a regular interval. When water is allowed to flow through the main pipe under pressure with the help of a pump, it escapes from the rotating nozzles, it gets sprinkled on the crop as if it is raining. Sprinkler is very useful for a sandy soil. Second is a drip system. In this system, the water falls drop by drop just at the position of the roots. So it is called drip system. It is the best technique for the watering fruity plants. Gardens and trees. The system provides water to plants drop by drop. Water is not wasted at all. It is a boon in regions where availability of water is poor. Protection from weeds. In a field, many other undesirable plants may grow naturally along with the crop. These undesirable plants are called weeds. The removal of weeds is called weeding. Weeding is necessary since weeds compete with the crop plants for water, nutrients, space, and light. Thus, they affect the growth of the crop. Some weeds interfere even in harvesting and may be poisonous for animals and human beings. Farmers adopt many ways to remove weeds and control their growth. Tilling before sowing of a crop helps in the uprooting and killing of weeds. which may then dry up and get mixed with the soil. The best time for the removal of weeds is before they produce flowers and seeds. The manual removal includes physical removal of weeds by uprooting or cutting them close to the ground from time to time. This is done with the help of khurpi. A seed drill is also used to uproot weeds. Weeds are also controlled by using certain chemicals called weedicides, like 2,4-D. These are sprayed in the fields to kill the weeds. They do not damage the crops. The weedicides are diluted with water to the extent required and sprayed in the field with the sprayer. As already mentioned, the weedicides are sprayed during the vegetative growth of weeds before flowering and seeds formation. Spraying of weedicides may affect the health of a farmer, so they should use these chemicals very carefully. They should cover their nose and mouth with a piece of cloth during spraying of these chemicals. Harvesting. Harvesting of a crop is an important task. The cutting of a crop after it is mature is called harvesting. In harvesting, crops are pulled out or cut close to the ground. It usually takes 3 to 4 months for cereal crops to mature. Harvesting in our country is either done manually by sickle or by a machine called harvester. In the harvested crop, the grain seeds need to be separated from the chaff. This process is called threshing. This is carried out with the help of a machine called combine, which is in effect a combined harvester and thresher. Farmers with small holding of land do the separation of grain and chaff by winnowing. Storage of a produce is an important task. If the crop grains are to be kept for a longer time, they should be safe from moisture, insects, rats, and microorganisms. The fresh crop has more moisture if freshly harvested grains are stored without drying. They may get spoiled or attached by organisms, losing their germination capacity. Hence, before storing them, the grains are properly dried in the sun to reduce the moisture in them. This prevents the attack by insects, pests, bacteria, and fungi. Farmers store grains in jute bags or metallic bins. However, large-scale storage of grains is done in silos and granaries to protect them from pests like rats and insects. Dried neem leaves are used for storing food grains at home. For storing large quantities of grains in big godowns, specific chemical treatments are required to protect them from pests and organisms. Food from animals. As you know, like plants, animals also provide us with different kinds of food. Many people living in the coastal areas consume fish as a major part of their diet. In the previous classes, you have learned about the food that we obtain from plants. We have just seen that the process of crop production involves a number of steps like selection of seeds, sowing, or etc. Similarly, animals reared at home or in farms have to be provided with proper food, shelter, and care. When this is done on a large scale, it is called animal husbandry. So, what you have learned? In order to provide food to our growing population, we need to adapt certain agriculture practices. Second, same kind of plants grown and cultivated at a place constitute a crop. In India, crops can be broadly categorized into two types based on seasons that are Rabi and Kharif crops. It is necessary to prepare soil by tilling and leveling. Ploughs and levelers are used for this purpose. Sowing of seeds at appropriate depths and distances gives good yield. Good variety of seeds are sown after selection of healthy seeds. Sowing is done by seed drills. Soil needs replenishment and enrichment through the use of organic manure and fertilizers. Use of chemical fertilizers has increased tremendously with the introduction of new crop variety. Supply of water to crops at appropriate intervals is called irrigation. Weeding involves removal of unwanted and uncultivated plants called weeds. Harvesting is the cutting of the mature crop manually or by machines. Separation of the grains from the chaff is called threshing. Proper storage of grains is necessary to protect them from the pests and microorganisms. And last is, food is also obtained from animals for which animals are reared. This is called animal husbandry.